Mike, he's put in three full practices. What's impressed you the most about his comeback?
Well, it's just a process. I mean, just that he can do it. He's out there. He didn't look too rusty. With that said, he's not ready to play right now. It's going to be a little bit of a process. We just have to hold the horses a little bit and get him back when he's ready to go.
The big question is explosiveness when you come back from an Achilles tear. How would you rate his explosiveness?
Well, I don't think he's trying to show it yet. He's just getting out there and getting in things. I don't think he really pushed off as hard as he can. Having said that, I have no idea.
Mike, you mentioned the event last night that he looked yesterday not quite as sharp.
Right. I think he was a little sore yesterday, you know, a little tired. It's like training camp. You know, about the third day, it's tough, and that's what he's kind of going through right now. So this is a normal process, and he's good.
Mike, you mentioned the process. What would you prioritize needs to happen for Kobe to come back and play?
Just when he's ready. He'll know it. Trainer will know it by looking at him, and I'll know it by looking at him. So I think it's all three of us sit down and try to figure out when it's the best. We could map it out on the calendar, but you don't know. You go day to day, and you figure out where he is today and where he'll be tomorrow. And then at some point, it looks good. I think everybody will agree, and we'll do it.
I did not see Chris Kamen out there. Did Chris Kamen practice?
He tweaked his back a little bit yesterday. He did not practice.
How did this mini camp for you go this week that you talked about earlier?
Good. I think the team, they look good. They look sharp and ready to roll. We're ready to play somebody.
Were you surprised Kobe didn't practice? Is that really surprising?
Nah, you know, not really. I don't think it's I don't think we should be surprised about anything. I think, like I said, it's a process. You'd be surprised if he played, and we knew he wasn't going to play. Y'all might be surprised, but it's just going to be a process. There's going to be days he'll have to take off and days that he'll ramp it up, but definitely not a surprise.
When you're saying compared to yesterday, the first day that he was tired, a little sore, where did you see
You know,
that?
We're getting into minutia that I don't know. I'm not a doctor, although I studied chemistry some, but, you know, I can't tell you. He looked pretty good. He's on target. He'll play when he plays, and that's all I know, guys. I can't break it down.
You know, I asked you the question about explosiveness. The other side of the ball, defensively, lateral movement. How are you seeing Kobe move defensively in those three practices?
Okay. I mean, again, just like somebody come back from an injury, and I thought it was good. I think everybody thought it was good, but, again, nothing that two or three weeks more practice, and you know, will make it better. Steve is progressing. I mean, he's still in the process of working out and working his getting back. He's not here yet.
Conditioning-wise?
Conditioning and trying to get over the nerve pain, just trying to get everything together, get his body aligned, and probably be another week or 10 days, and then he'll try it. And if it works, it works. If not, he'll go back to try it again.
Is there a sense that it is promising, though?
I mean, I don't know. It's too early. Yeah.
Was it a setback?
No, I don't know. I think it's normal. You know, I just think he probably, you know, I don't want to talk for him, but he was going so good, so hard. I mean, you know, it's just a normal process, and you got to make sure that he's not going to play tomorrow, so be careful with it and then take our time.